If you have a client who is in the process of selling a business and there are benefits to bringing in a financial planner to the conversation, at what point does the attorney get involved?
If you're asking me, yesterday. If you don't have an attorney doing pre-sale planning along with a financial advisor, you're making a mistake. The idea of a financial advisor is you're thinking about, hey, I'm going to receive some money, I want to invest it and manage it properly for my future. To not think about the structure in which that portfolio will rest is a mistake. And the sooner you bring in the lawyer, the better.
Yeah, so if you bring in the lawyer yesterday, then the invoice goes out 2 days ago. So you want to get the invoice for yourself first, okay? And then I think you want to be a part of that process, be involved, then select who's going to be on the team so you're at least the point person. Like he said, there may be some conversations that you're not going to be involved in, which is totally fine. But if you're going to be running quarterback on a variety of different tasks associated with that, I would get them to commit to go through that rather than referring them out. Because if you just refer them out, they're going to probably go to an attorney, let's say, to that attorney that you referred. Then that attorney's going to refer them either to their internal accounting department or another tax department or something like that. Then you're just kind of like, somebody's doing it, but you're not doing it because you just didn't ask for the money, right? And maybe that person didn't come to a conference like this and doesn't have access to the resources like this. So I think you want to be involved in it as well. That doesn't mean you're controlling every single thing, but get paid first, get everybody involved. That needs to make sense.